Hi, my name is Thomas Kim. This is 11th video about template metaprogramming. In this session, we will learn how to use STD variant. STD variant was introduced to C++ 17 standard. Using STD variant, we will create a container class that can hold heterogeneous elements. More about STD variant, please visit this website, then you can find more information about variant. And also, if you haven't watched my previous videos about template metaprogramming, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and watch my other videos about template metaprogramming. Start Visual Studio 2017. Because variant is introduced in C++ standard 17, we need to have Visual Studio 2017. From File menu, New Project, Visual C++, Windows Desktop Wizard, Variant, Solution, 01, Variant. Click OK. Unselect precompiled header. Make sure console application is selected. Click OK. Right-click the project, Properties. Make sure all configuration, all platform selected. C++, Language. Select C++ 17 standard. Click OK. I will remove this part of code. We will include variant, include type traits, include string, include vector. Then here we will try some basics about variant, STD, variant. We provide type int, double, then STD string. We create a variant instance like this. Then here we can initialize variant, like this is integer type we initialized. We can also change the value to double. Also, we can change the value Thomas Kim, like this way. Now here we can display the value std cout std get. Get 0 means the first type. The first type here we provide va. Va is variant, std, and there. Here again, std, cout, std, get. We can access second element, double. We give index 1, va, std, and there. Then here, we can provide another one, cout, std, get. This is third element, std, string, va, std, and there. So this is the most basic way to access declare variant variables. Then we can access each element. We can change the value of va variant. Control F5. Okay, we have the result like this. Say, we can also access like this. STD, cout, STD, get, int. We provide a type, va, STD, and there. Here, STD, cout, STD. Since this is type double, get, double, va, std, and there. Okay, and here std, cout, std, get, std, string, va, std, and there. If we can also provide index here, this is index, so this is 2. Now control F5. Okay, the result is displayed like this. Now we are trying another way. STD, cout, STD, get, 0, index 0, index 1, index 2. If we provide index 3, std and there, it will crash. Okay, it will crash at runtime. Control F5. It doesn't build. Or in some case, currently, this is currently integral type. If we try to access std get double std and there, it will cause current value of va is integral type, but we are trying to access type double, then it will throw exception. Control F5. It crashed because it violated access here. Then we can wrap with try like this. Catch std bad variant access e std cout e what and there. So if we run it here, so access bad variant access, it is caused from here. Instead, we have another way to access. Before we try to access another way, now I will change it like this. Since when we access variables using type, this can be a little bit confusing. We want to give names to this type like this, using age t int, using weight t double, using name t std. If we introduce type alias, this is called a type alias template, then we can change like this. Age t weight t name t, then instead of int we can say age t. It's much more descriptive. This is weight t, this is name t. Accessing this way is much more descriptive. Okay, so this way of accessing is much more descriptive. Okay, like this. Also, accessing this number, literal number, can be pretty confusing when we have big variance with many elements. Accessing this indexing can be confusing. Instead of doing this, we can do like this. Enum size t index age, or I can just say idx age, idx weight, idx name. By introducing this named enumeration, we can do like this. Instead of doing this, we can say idx age, idx weight, here idx name. This way of accessing is much simpler. Now Control F5, much more descriptive. Okay, so I will make it into a function. Test variant basic, I will name like this. Then I will copy this part of code. Then you can say test variant basics. Okay, the code is actually the same. Okay, another way we can access is something like this. I will do the same in another way. Void test get if. Okay, I'm creating another variant, another function. I will do like this. Try catch std bad variant access e std cout e what. Now here We will introduce the same A using H, T, INT, for example, using name, I would say name, T, STD, string, using gender, it will be character. So we can also make like this. We make another enum, enum size t, idx, age, idx, name, idx, gender. Please note that we have to preserve the order. I will order like this, then std variant. We will be using type age t, then gender. We will be using this gender t, then we will be using name t, I would say person. I created a type of variable, variant. Then we can access the same A, person. I will provide this is integer of age type, so 30. Then I can access like this. If auto, I would say if std get if age t, we are providing this person here, son, but in this case we have to provide address like this, then auto age, ph. Okay, if it is successful, then it will return pointer, then we can provide like this, stdc out age is ph std, and there else if auto p name std get if name t, we can provide gender in this case, or name t doesn't matter, we will say gender t person. Here std c out gender p gender. I will change it to p gender like this. Else if auto p name std get if name t person, then we can access name is p name. Okay, we will test this function, get if control F5. Okay, age is 30. Okay, so if we change it to like gender F, control F5, then it displays like this, gender is F. Okay, so this way we can access we can try the type, then we can access. There is another way, std c out std, and there now we will change the person, person we will change it into name Thomas Kim, for example. We changed the contents of person like this. Then in the same manner we can access another way, auto ph like this, std get if, instead of providing type, this is type, int type, we can also provide index like this, idx, this is age, right? Then we provide person. We can access the same A like this, std here, my age, std, ph, ph, we can access this way too. We are using index, this is index, else if, or p gender, std, get, if, idx, gender, then person, std, cout, my gender is p gender, std, and else if, or p name, std, get, if, idx, name, person, std, cout, my name is std, get, no, p name, std, and there. Now let's try it once again. Ctrl F5. Okay, my gender is F, my name is Thomas Kim. We have changed, like, we can access two way using get if. First, we access using type, this is type. And another way is index, this is index, okay? So this way we can access each element of variant. Now we will test another one, void test variant info. We will test some basic informations about variant, std, variant, int, long. For example, if we provide va, we can also initialize when we create 5l. Okay, so it means we are declaring va, then we initialize with the 5l, or we can say 5l std cout count of types, say element types. Here we can access like this, std variant size. Okay, so we provide decl type va std and there. Okay, let's try it. Test variant info, test variant info, Ctrl F5. Okay, I missed this one, Ctrl F5. Okay, count of element types. So it has two element types, int and long. So another thing we need to know is that std variant v, this is not supported. We have to provide at least one or more element. If we compile it, it doesn't compile. So in sometimes we want to provide some uninitialized data type or null type, default data type, then we can use std mono state. In this case, this is used as dummy data type that does not include any data element. Okay, in this case, let's run it again. Now it builds. Okay, count of element 2, it is accessing this one. We can also allow std mono state. We can also initialize like this. Then Ctrl F5, it works the same way, but now in this case, count of element type is 3, because 1, 2, 3. Okay, we can also access like this. Now I will enclose these to try catch block, try catch std bad access, bad variant access in std cout e what is the end there. Okay, I'll put some description here. STD, variant, size, V, returns the number of element types. We want to display each element. Is it possible? STD cout VA and there. So we want to overload operator, this output operator like this. If we compile it, it doesn't work. It doesn't, operator is not defined, okay? So we will implement this operator for variant, for arbitrary data type. To do that, we can do like this. I will define here, template, type name, VType. VType means variant type, struct, SD, variant, utilities, okay? This is primary template, primary template, class template. Then we specialize template, type name, head, type name, tails, struct, SD, variant, utils. Then we have to provide one argument here, STD, variant, head, tails. Like this, okay? Now here, we will compute constexpr, static, constexpr, size t, trail element count. We say element type count std variant variant size. We can provide this type like this, then it returns element count. Okay, we actually used this variable template. We learned it here. We are using this variable template. Then we will define here var variant type std variant head tails. Then we can change it like this. We can fix like this. Okay, it's much shorter. Okay. Then here we are defining one function template type name front. Type name, I would say remainders, static, void, print, std, or stream, os. We have this type variant, constant variant type, v. We are at this point here. Now we compute index constant constexpr size t. We are counting remainders count, remainders count, size of remainders like this. Then we can count the remainder count here. We will count index constexpr size t index. We subtract from here type count minus remainders count minus 1. Then we can access element like this. If constexpr index equals v index, it returns currently selected element index. This is runtime construct. This is compile time constant. Then we can say OS. This is the OS here. STD get index like this. Then else. At this point, we are testing if context field, this is remainder, count of remainder, remainder count is not zero, then we call this function once again, print os b, then we have to provide here template parameter remainders, and once again, if the mono state, the first element is mono state, we are also providing mono state here, so we can also further change like this. If context field front std is same b, front is the type of this front is the same as std mono state, then if it is not, then this part of code will be executed. Now using this print function, we can implement operator like this, template type name, head type name, tails std or stream operator std or stream os, then constant std variant head tails v like this. We introduced like this, then here st variant utils, we will create a type here, type name var variant t, we can define variant type like this, then here variant t, then print head tails os v, okay, return os. Please note that this is template, and this is also template member function. We have to provide keyword template like this. Okay, if we don't provide keyword template here, it will give error message. Okay, now with this this is now possible. Okay, now it works. Control F5. Let's check what's the problem. Expression did not evaluate to constant. Sorry, this should be runtime construct. We have to modify like this because this is runtime construct. We have to fix like this. Control F5 again. Okay, it works. Now if we change it, if we try it more, let's test it a little bit more here. VA, I will also put it std string, then I can change it to string, the C++ programmer, then let's run it. Okay, the C++ programmer. I will introduce template type name cls class cntr, this is container type name, no, we'll say front type name types, okay, using varcntrt. Varcntrt means variable container, then cntr std variant front types, then with this we include vector and string. Also, we can include dequeue or some other method. Then here we will test We will test one more here. Void. VAR, CNT, CNTR. VAR, CNTR. Okay, VAR, CNTR. Now here we can do like this. VAR, CNTR, T. We provide a container, vector. We provide int, double, character, std, string, va, vcn. I will say vcn. We can initialize like this, arbitrarily, 10, 3.1, and female, James, 30, male, Stephen. We can put arbitrary elements with one integer, double, character, string. Among four type, we can put arbitrary data type as vector element. This is vector element. Then we can access and display like this. For oro, e, bcn, here, std, cout, e, cout, std, and there, like this. Now we test this function. Control F5. Okay, it works successfully. Please note that this var, cntr, t can hold arbitrary, I would say, can hold heterogeneous elements, heterogeneous type of elements. And we can also access it another way, like this. I will define here. If we are accessing like this, it can be a little bit confusing. So using aged int, using weight t double, using gender t character, using name t std okay std string. We will also introduce enumeration enum, size t, idx, age, idx, weight, idx, gender, idx, name. Okay, we can also declare this will be used as index. This enum will be used as numbered index. We can also access like this. Here, instead of just displaying, you can say if oro p age std get, if age t here e, then std cl age is ph std and there. Okay, else if oro p weight std get, if weight e std cout weight is p weight, and else if oro p gender std get, if gender t e std cout gender is here. We can do like this. Let's see. gender app female else male. Well, if we want to, we can also do like this for lowercase letter else if auto p name std get if name t e std c out name is p name. Now let's build and run. Control F5. See? So the first element is 10, age is 10. The second 3.14, this is weight 3.14. F is male, gender is male, this is female. We made mistake here. It should be or. Okay, now close it. Let's build once again. Control F5. Okay. So A here, female, and the name is James. Then 30, age is 30, M is gender is male, name is Steve. So in this container we can hold heterogeneous data type in this container. And there is another way to access. This is, in this case, this is loop based, if statement based. We can also create the same way using switch. Okay, switch statement. Let's try with the switch statement. I copied it here. Now we will try with the switch. We can do like this: SWITCH switch e index. Okay, it returns index. Then I will change it to switch statement case. We defined index here, so we have to compare with this enumeration case IDX age. Then we can say, I will make it simple. STD get if we can just say get IDX age, then we will break case IDX gender weight. This is weight. Then we can modify like this STD get IDX weight. Sorry, I forgot here one thing. Here I have to provide E and break here, break case IDX gender. Gender is, yes. Then here we have to say auto gender std get IDX gender e. Okay. So instead of doing this, we have to change like this gender. Okay, I fixed. Then we have to break case IDX name. You can change like this here, break Okay, this is switch. Then loop. Okay. Now let's try it. This function is test VCL and T this one. Control F5. Sorry, we made a mistake here. You also have to change STD. Get IDX name E. Control F5. Okay, so in this case, we are accessing each element using type. These are type or data type, field type. And in this case, we are accessing index, literal number, using index of the element. So this way, we can access and create arbitrary heterogeneous container class. We will add one more function to convert variant to string. In this class, we will copy this part of code like this, then rename it to string. STD string, it returns string to string like this. Then we don't need this. And here we declare std string str. This is null string. Here. We can say std or string. OS, then here str OS str, and then we return. We can just return here. No, then here str like this. Then here, return OS, return str. Then with this function, we will be using this function. Here, we will copy this part, this code. Paste it. Then here, std string. To string, then we don't need this. Then here, return. Now we are calling this function to string function. Here, to string. Then we don't need this. Okay, with this function, now we can test finally. To string. I would say test to string like this. Then instead of doing this, we can still do like this, but we can change it much easier way. We can say to string here to string. Here, I will just leave it here to string. Then it becomes much simpler. test to string. Control F5. We have to remove this. And we also have to change this to string. We fixed. Then Control F5. We have to include stream. Now Control F5. Okay, it works. And finally, we will add overload one more functions. Template type name T std or string operator std or string os std constant std vector t b if empty os else or last element. Here std advanced v and -1 std c out for auto itr v begin itr last element itr std c out itr std c out last element std and there. With this, now we can change something like this. Void test var cntr display. You can say var cntr t std vector int double std string va chain for Thomas James 30. We can put arbitrary data, we initialize arbitrary way, then std cout va std and there. Now let's test it. Test var cntr display. Now Control F5. we have to include algorithm. I think this is advanced. And here, Control F5. Sorry, I will modify it, I will fix it. SED, advance, last element, -1, then it should be OS, and it also should be OS, and it's also OS, and we have to return OS. Control F5. Okay, it works. So I will here I will fix James, Steve. We can put arbitrary number of elements here. Sophia. Also, if we want to insert some, for example, character, you can also put character like this. So this way we can finally control F5. Okay, it works. So this way we can create a vector or container class that supports arbitrary heterogeneous type of elements. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.